Now we are going to see about this synchronous counter using modulo or mod bit. Okay, so in the previous section in asynchronous counter we have studied about the mod 8, mod 10, mod 5, mod 3, like that we have seen different mod bit. So what we had did in that state, which data was given, which mode was given, we used to write 1 in that mode. If it is a mode 6, you will write 1 in the present state, you will give 6 as 1, all the above terms will be 0 and the below terms will be, you are giving don't care. The same procedure you are going to do over here, but the only difference is that you are not going to give a 1 over here, you are going to express the next state that is going to happen over there. Okay, so the same thing that we studied in the previous class also, this counter will, you have to design the data and the clocks will be given simultaneously. Okay, so first question, let consider as a design a mode 6 synchronous up counter using T flip flop. Okay, so you are going to design a mode 6. It is a synchronous counter, so you can consider as a synchronous up counter using T flip flop. Okay, now here, as it is a 6 bit, you have to represent 6, you have to know how many flip flops you have to take. So it gives us 2 raised to 3, so 3 flip flops are required. That means you need Q3, Q2, Q1, and your next state will depend upon the Q3 plus, Q2 plus, Q1 plus, and the excitation table T3, T2, T1. Okay. This is the present state, this is the next state, this is the excitation table. Okay. Now, what we have to do? We have to go to the states. So your states can be represented as, your state should pass to, only 6 states should be passed. That means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you have to pass only 6 states. 0 to 5, 6 states should be passed. Okay, this is an up counter. So you can directly write it as, you can directly give this as, your data is passing from 0 to 5. Okay, so your present state goes to 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0 and 1, 1, 1. You have to write the present state. As it is a 2 raised to 3. 3 flip-flop, you know your data should pass from 0 to 7. Okay. So, you are writing all the 3 state, all the bits over here. Next, what you have to do? You have to go to an up counter. So, next to 0, the up will go to 0, 0, 1. So, you have to pass from 0, 0, 0 to 0, 1, 0, 1. That means 0 to 5. 6 states should be there. Okay, according to that you have to represent your next state. 0, 0, 1 goes to 0, 1, 0. 0, 1, 0 will go to 0, 1, 1. 1, 1 will go to 1, 0, 0. 1, 0, 0 will go to 1, 0, 1. So I told you, your data should pass from 0 to 5. And 5 should go back to 0. Okay, and the 6 and 7 will be your don't care over here. You don't have that state, so it will be don't care. One, two, three, four, five, six. So you will get the all these 6 states over here. Your data passes from 0 to 6. 0 to 5, 6 states will be there. That's the only difference that you have to understand. Here, one bit should be up. Over there, asynchronous counter used to give which data, which bit was given. If it is given mode 6, you have to give 1 to 110, you have to give 1. All the data 0 to 5 should be 0 and 7 should be don't care. Here, which state is given, previous to that state you have to give that end number. That means if it is 5, you have to go to back to 0. So next clock should not work. Okay. So depending upon that, you have to write your excitation table. It's a must. You have to write excitation table over here. So your excitation table for T, that means Q A and Q A plus, your T will be, if it is 0, 0, it will be 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 0, 1, 1, 1, data will be 0. So depending upon it, you have to write your excitation table. Okay. Now, coming back to your truth table, Q3 plus 0, 0. 0, 0, it will be 0. Okay. Again, 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. Next, 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0. 1, 1, 0. 0, 1, 1. 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1. 1, 0, 1. 1, 1, 0. 0, 0, 0. 0, 1, 1. 1, 0, 1. 0, 0, 0. 1, 0, 1. Here you don't have, so you can give that as don't cast it. Okay. Now you can directly see your T1, everything is given as 1, 1, 1, 1 and XX. So you can directly give it as 1. Your output will be 1. Either you can go through this. I told you, if all the datas are 1 and having a don't care over there, you can directly give it as 1. Now you have to find the K-map for T2 and T3. So T2, it's a 3-bit data. Your data varies from Q3, Q2, Q1. So Q3, Q2, Q1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0, Q3, Q2, Q1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. Okay. So you have to find T3 and T2. T3 is equal to, T2 is equal to. So for T3, you know 0, 0, 0, 1. First bit it will go for 0, 0, 0, 1. Then 0, 1, XX. 0, 1, XX. Next data you will go for 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, XX. So grouping, you can't go for, you can go for grouping. Here you have 2-bit. And here also. So you will get for this Q2, Q1 plus Q3, Q1, and over here you will get Q3 bar, Q1. Okay. So you got all the three things. Now you can draw that using your T flip-flop. This is the design part that will be asking over for in various questions will be asked over there. Design a 3-bit, design a synchronous modulo 6 gray counter. For that, what you have to do? You have to represent your gray count code over here. 0 to 7, until 0 to 7, what is your gray code? You have to represent over them. Your next statement depends upon that gray code. So if it is 001, and next was 011, your next state over here will be 011. Like that, you have to do it according to your present state. What is your present state? According to that, you have to go for your next state. Okay, then this is a synchronous counter, so you're giving simultaneous clocking over there. And T1, Q1, Q1 bar, T2, Q2, Q2 bar, T3, Q3, Q3 bar. So T1 is 1, T2 is, it's an AND gate, so Q3 bar, Q1, T3, Q2, Q1, Q3, Q1, you have to AND this, sorry, it's not, you can't draw like that. Okay, now you can give it as Q2, Q1. Okay, this is Q3, Q1. Both you have to, or if there's a plus over there, so you're giving to an OR gate, and that will go to as a input to T3. Okay, and your output will be from Q1. Here it should take it from Q2. I can't draw that. You have to take from Q3. Instead of giving the direct connection, you can do like this. Okay. So this is the design part. Whatever data is given for you, if it is a mode 8, that means your present state should go from 8 to raised to 4. That means your data should passes from 0 to 15. So you have to write the entire data from 000 to 1111, and it is a mode 8, so the data passes from 0 to 7. Okay, 8, for 8 it will be, 8 onwards it will be a down case state. So depending upon that, you can draw your truth table. You can write your whatever data is given or whatever flip flop is asked in, for that you can give your excitation table, and then you have to represent the data in your K map, and according to that you have to draw. Suppose it will be asking you design a mode 10 counter, or mode 10 you have to know. You can give, I will give you different questions related to that. Okay, design a mode 10 or decade or counter. They will ask you either a mode 10 or a decade counter or modulo 10, like that they will ask. So you have to know decade is also 10. Mode 10 counter using D flip flop. All the procedures are same. You just know to want to understand data process from 0 to 9. It should have 10 states. So hint is that 0 to 9, 10 states. So from 10 onwards, here you know from 6 onwards. From 6 it went to don't care. Here from 10 it should go for don't care. Other data should pass according to it. So here it is not given as any up counter or down counter. You can directly go for up counter. Okay, next, design a mode 6 gray counter using T flip flop. Okay, 3, design a modulo 9 counter using let it be JK flip-flop. It will be little bit lengthy, but if you do, you will be able to understand it more clearly. Okay, so work out these three problems and the previous problem, then you will be able to understand the synchronous counter in a good manner. Okay, thank you.